what we did this morning. Didn't get it on video, but we stopped at the creek. I think they got us some shad, brother. Here you go. All you catfishermen out there, this is what you want right here. This is the deal. Fresh. Let me cut one up. 4-2. So y'all know how I like to cut shad. Take the head off. Look at that blood. I like to take the bellies out because the gut pocket will spin underwater. Don't like that. So let's get a little chum down there. Cut us some chunks, different sizes. Get rid of that tail piece. We'll save that little chunk for later. Let me get another one. We'll cut a couple up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We'll start out with 6 rods. Oh man, look at that blood. Mmm. Yummy. Through that gut pocket. Give me some chunks, baby. Nice chunks. Alright, get rid of that tail piece. Ah. I ain't gonna put too many rods out right now, I think, Vince, because until the tide starts moving, we'll put a couple of test rods out. Let's see, let me try this end one. Ain't bad. Water temperature's what? 65 degrees. We might could catch one or two today, I hope. You know, my last Sunday trip was pretty sad. I'm gonna put this one straight on the bottom with no float. Put a nice bloody chunk on there. Just remember, fellas, when you hook these shad, make sure you check that hook tip. Don't want no scale. You get a scale on that hook tip, Vince. You always want to make sure that's nice and clear. That way if the fish comes to bite it, if there's a piece of scale on there, it won't penetrate their jaw. Don't worry too much about getting blood on my cork. It adds character to the cork. All right, first cast. It's going down. Yep, a little too deep, that's good. I'm not gonna put too many more out, just like one. The current's going to be changing on us in a minute.